better. Like,
get home in the bed, like, you just be on the phone.
Someone needs some jail time.
Right.
I need a pass to my counselor.
Good morning to you too.
I need a schedule change.
Yeah, why do we have two science classes?
Oh, now, y'all know why y'all have two science classes.
Ooh, what's that supposed to mean?
You know exactly what that means.
Ooh, you know what? These teachers been trying it today. First you got Mrs. Scott, this huge algebra packet, and Miss Taylor with this, like, 10-page essay. Like, oh my gosh, like, what is going
right.
on?
Coach Rogers forcing us to eat spaghetti in the morning.
That sounds like abuse.
He literally does this all the time. And I haven't told anyone. And then when we get to his PE class, he makes us run 3 miles.
Oh my goodness. You need an adult. You want
me
to call your mama?
Okay, cut the drama. Now you know you're on the cross-country team. Eating pasta before a race is a very common strategy for runners.
Wait, what? Why?
Well, remember in physical science, we talked about how everything in our world is made of atoms. And those atoms form different compounds and molecules.
Why are we in so many classes with you? Like,
the molecules that make up pasta, or carbohydrates, are arranged in a specific way. And that structure determines how they function in our bodies.
I don't remember you saying anything about carbs when we were looking at the periodic table.
Yep. And my mama said carbs are bad for you.
Neither of those things are entirely true. So the periodic table has a lot of elements, but most of these are not necessary for living things. You'll find most living things contain these elements: carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, and sulfur. If you forget that, maybe think of chomps. And most living things contain a lot of carbon, but we rarely get these elements in their purest, simplest form. We get them as molecules like water and carbon dioxide. But even those small molecules are produced from larger molecules called macromolecules. There are 4 macromolecules: carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids. Sometimes your teacher may refer to these as biomolecules. And you also probably learned that we obtain and reuse these elements in the different biogeochemical cycles. But the main way we obtain these nutrients are through our food. Carbs come from
fatty foods, like real fat, like
not necessarily.
Well, people are always talking about how bad they are for you and going on low-carb diets.
That's very true, but we'll talk about that in a moment. Carbs come from any plant or any product that derives from plants.
Oh, so just fruits and vegetables? I thought bread was a carb.
Well, I didn't say carbs are fruits and vegetables. I said carbs come from plants. So wheat, the plant from which bread is made, well then bread comes from plants. Same with pasta. That spaghetti that you were crying about earlier also comes from wheat. Proteins come from animals or things derived from animals, and also some nuts and beans. Lipids are found in fatty or greasy foods like butter, oil. And nucleic acids can be found in almost everything.
Oh, okay, so lipids are the bad guys, not carbs. Carbs are good? Got it. Okay.
Not necessarily. To understand why they behave the way that they do, we have to look at their structure. These are called macromolecules because they're made of smaller molecules bonded together. These smaller units are known as monomers. Here are the monomers of carbs and lipids. What are some similarities and differences that you notice between the two?
Well, it looks like they both have a lot of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen.
True, but lipids have many more of them though. Like, you see all of them?
Right. Both carbs and lipid monomers have many carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen atoms bonded together. And when those bonds are broken, when we're digesting our food, we get energy from that. So think about it. If you are ever in desperate need of energy for a long time, which one of these would you prefer to use?
The lipid. It has much, much more carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen.
Exactly. Lipids or fats are essential because they help store that energy whenever our body may need it. If you happen to starve, your body can survive for a few days.
That makes sense.
By breaking down the fat molecules stored in your body. But if you needed energy right away, which would be best?
Oh, the carb.
Right. The monomer for carbohydrates are called monosaccharides. Joined together, they make a polymer. We can call those polysaccharides, or you could really just call it a carbohydrate altogether. So if you had to run a race, loading up on bread and pasta would actually be very beneficial because your body will use it quickly for energy.
Oh, okay, so I don't need to call the police on Coach Rogers?
Still call them.
And after that race, when your muscles are worn down and need to recover, it's best to eat meat or some lean source of these guys.
That doesn't look like meat to me.
Well, what do you notice that's present here that was not in our carbs and lipids?
Ooh, I see an N, like nitrogen?
Right. This monomer is called an amino acid. When you connect them together, you get polypeptides, or proteins. And proteins help to carry out so many essential functions in our bodies. They form enzymes for digestion and respiration that help to break down those carbs and lipids you eat.
Oh, I saw Miss Narain's class doing that. We never do anything in your class. Like, we just sit here and talk.
They control the color of our skin, our eyes. They help to rebuild muscles, nails, and hair. And these guys right here are responsible for making the blueprint that codes for all of our proteins.
Our DNA?
Yes. These monomers are called nucleotides. And they have even more of those essential elements we talked about. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, in the sugar, a phosphate, and a nitrogenous base. And if you put all of these monomers together, you'll get the nucleic acids, DNA, and RNA that code for our proteins. And you can find the nucleic acids in
everything. Every organism would have DNA or RNA in it, right?
Exactly.
Ooh, okay, let me call my mama and tell her to stop that no-carb diet right now, because
The four macromolecules carry out so many functions for living things, and none of them are bad, in moderation. Too many lipids or fats, yes, that may be stored on our bodies in certain places longer than we may like, but they serve a great purpose in the long run. They keep us warm, allowing bears to hibernate through long winters with little or no food, and tons of energy to stay alive. Carbs aren't all bad, depending on their structures. If I wanted to load up before a race, eating pasta from whole grains and not enriched refined pasta or processed carbs, they digest very quickly, spike your blood sugar, and cause you to feel full much sooner, which leads to overeating, which causes weight gain and other problems. So, none of the macromolecules are truly bad. It just depends on the source and their structure.
You really need some complex carbs. Like, look at your neck. It's like the size of a baby's index finger. Like, you're turned to the side right now, and like, you almost disappeared.
Yeah, he kind of looks like a male Bratz doll. You remember those Bratz dolls with like the huge heads and the small bodies?
Emaciated, starving. Where do you even buy clothes that are that small?
Okay.
Let's see if I say something bad.
I don't even know. How do you even fit in?
He's like 52, still shopping at Baby Gap.
You actually don't look that different from him, to be honest. None of us do, for real.